Hello everybody, and welcome to Flat Earthers. This is a super flat survival SMP ran by Mogswamp, who is really awesome. He has several years under his belt living in a super flat world. If you haven't checked him out before, I'll leave a link down in the description so you could give him a good look for yourself. Really awesome guy. Got some cool stuff going on, got amazing builds. Really fun to watch. I would recommend checking out his world, you know, starting off with his latest world tour episode and working from there. Or you go all the way back and kind of like see how things progressed over time. I think it's really cool. But this is a super flat SMP. We got several people on. I'm at the little start of my journey. Accidental face zoom. And, you know, I was coming from my hardcore world, so I got my little work wagons. I got a couple of wagons here that I brought with me. Unfortunately, oh, there's my horse. See, I got my work horses over there. We just rode all of our carriages over and joined them. So it feels kind of weird knowing I can die and respawn, because I've normally when I play super flat, I'm in hardcore or I'm in my test world. So both of those, death is not an option. So it's pretty cool. It's fun. We are going to get started on a few things. We'll go over what we have. I have my potato garden, a wheat garden, a carrot one, and a little bit of sugar cane. I got a handful of different tree types. I still need jungle birch and dark oak. Yes, dark oak. There we go. That was the one I was missing. Every villager that was in this village, I think with the exception of one who got eaten by a zombie, I trapped in, you know, my state-of-the-art fence design. All I do is build a fence, put their beds in the middle, and when it comes nighttime, they come jumping in and can't get out. It's like the fastest way to capture all of them. And, it's not the safest by any means. The zombie could still probably smack them through the fence. But it's worked out. We haven't had any more losses. Actually, we've had some breeding going on. I have a couple of guys who don't have jobs. But this is where I'm getting some of my stones. I want a lot of decorative stones. I probably need to get a cleric in there so I can get some redstone for some future projects. But at the moment, we're doing pretty good. One of the things I do want to get started on, though. Oh, yeah, and this is all I have, by the way. Other than my handy-dandy wagons. I want to get started on a really easy cobblestone generator, and we're going to build it together. So this is the stuff you need. This is not the exact amount of blocks. Just pick any, you know, fire resistance blocks. Or if you got fire spread turn off, pick any blocks you want. We're just going to use these because I have tore a couple of those houses down. I'm still going to go collect some more. It's like, you know, it's my favorite way of getting white terracotta. I can just tear down villager houses. I have to tear them down anyways. So, yeah, let's go ahead and get our stuff, pick a place, and get started. And this is where we're going to build the cobblestone generator. We're going to make it look a little bit nicer, you know, when we have some more blocks. But at the moment, we're just going to get the machine built. So what you want to do is start off by placing four double chests, like so, right? And, I mean, you could technically add more if you want to, but we're going to try to make this guy simple, especially if you're playing on a super flat, where you got to kill some of your iron golems at the start by hand. So the less you got to kill, the easier it makes it. And the next, what we're going to do is place hoppers facing into the chest. You tell they're facing into the chest by that little tail right there going into it. And next thing you want to do is take four staircases and place them on top, like so. And we're going to go ahead and starting kind of like half of this chest, we're going to wrap around the cobblestone generator, like so. And then we're going to go up one more block and do the same. There we go. Now, next thing you want to do, and make sure I have a way to get up and down. I do. We're going to put one this way, though. We are going to waterlog each stair. So it's good to have an infinite water source nearby to kind of make this a little bit easier. And there we go. Once you have all of your upstairs waterlogged, go ahead and place some blocks up here. And then you could go ahead and just wrap it around one more time. Next, we're going to need our lava bucket. And as close as you can to the middle, so one of these two middle blocks, you could place a lava there. If you got two lavas, I guess you could place them both in the middle. Or if you want to build this five long, you can. I was just trying to keep it, simple on the resources. One thing I forgot to get is a sign. You do need a sign, but I have them made right here, so that makes things a little bit easier. Choose which side you want to, mine your cobblestone from. Pop a hole in the wall, and before you mine that one, go ahead and plop you a sign down. It can say whatever or say nothing at all. Okay, and all I did was add a little roof on it with some of the slabs I got from the blacksmith over there. And you don't have to do that, but I don't know whether or not the server is fire tick is turned on and off. And I do it just for a little bit more safety because I want to build a cool structure around this later. So as much fireproof as we can, we're going to do it. But other than that, you could just go ahead and mine. I rarely reach the third block with an iron or stone pick. I haven't tested this with a diamond or like enchanted diamond and stuff like that. But it seems to be working pretty good. It collects the cobblestone for you. I don't know the difference between these two cobblestones, but alright. That was a little weird. But yeah, there we go. That's one machine done in our little project area. There's a couple other things I want to work on. We're going to go ahead and make an area for like a basic area for smelting. I think that will help us get started too. We need a thing that smelts stone, and we need maybe like a charcoal maker. I don't have a lot of ways to get coal yet because I'm not in the nether. So we're going to go ahead and get started on that. Okay, and I think I'm going to want it beside the cobblestone generator just because, it makes things a little bit easier. Like I could just pull it out of here and then smelt it when I need it. I don't really have silk touch yet. So we're going to go ahead and kind of lay this out. I'm just going to put a couple of temporary blocks to put our furnaces on. And then, get rid of the temporary blocks. Take out our chest. Put one double chest here. Come out the back. Put a couple of furnaces, or not furnaces, but hoppers. And then come out the front. And kind of jump click them into there. There we go. And that's going to be our little smelter. We can just come down this row and pick it out and put it in. This guy right here not leaving us alone. Come on. I have so many of you slimes. Alright, that's fine for now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get up a bunch of wood so I could go ahead and get some charcoal making. So we can eventually get stone out of this guy for our building purposes, and to also sell to the villagers because they buy stone, and I like having a stockpile of brick. I do have a little bit of brick from trading vegetables and paper and whatnot. I have bukus of slime. This is the slime cart. We almost have another stack of blocks, or a stack of blocks right there. We're doing all right. Alright, while waiting for some charcoal to make, I went ahead and took up my garden, but I had an awesome idea, and I don't know if it's going to work, so we're going to try it out together. If it doesn't work, I apologize for the waste of time, but it's been bugging my mind ever since I thought about it, so now I definitely got to try it, right? It's one of those things. I can't help to test in-game mechanics, and right now I have iron golems spawning like crazy to go fight slimes. They even spawn in this house, and they were getting stuck at one point, so I had to let them out of the house. I'm thinking if they don't spawn on the path blocks, right, I could path this entire spot, all but the house, and let them spawn in the house, and then find a way for them to fall into a hole and burn in lava and make kind of like this rigged up iron farm out of a villager house. So we're going to attempt that. I'm going to go ahead and start pathing all of this and digging out what I was talking about and seeing what we could come up with. Okay, and we got it working. It's been working pretty good. I'm going to go over this weird design. That's an iron golem dying in it now. Slowly. I'm actually quite shocked that this works. But at the same time, I'm not. It's one of those things, like, you think in your brain it should work. But you know how Minecraft likes to mess with you. And it doesn't work. Well, this is one of those things. And it's been working pretty good. I mean, I got 17 iron and 2 poppies so far. And it's a little bit slow because you have to rely on the iron golem to walk over here on his own. To tempt them a little bit, I did put some slimes within their vision, right? So they'll see the slimes and then go, oh, I want to kick that guy's butt. And then they'll get over here and burn to death in their little patch. This took way longer to set up than I would like to admit, but we have everything kind of pathwayed over. I even went into their little trading spot and pathed some of their blocks. I haven't seen one spawn in there yet, and I haven't seen any of them spawn on the path blocks yet. The only place I've seen them spawn was inside this house, and yeah, it's been working out pretty good, I think. Unfortunately, I wasted so much time on this that it is all I have time for. Oh man. Okay, so I know I need to path a little bit further off. I will have to do that off camera and hopefully get it to work. But I wasn't too sure about the radius, but it does make sense that the backside should have a lot more to it now that I think about it. I'll probably have to take this house down and just path this whole back. But it is all I got time for in today's episode. I will see you in the next one. Hopefully in the next one we'll get started on a little place to live so I'm not living out of my wagons. We do have a full set of charcoal now. And it looks like it's done melting. Either that or we ran out of logs to burn. We did run out of logs to burn. That's okay. We can use some of the charcoal we've been making to make more charcoal. And that'd be it. That's awesome. So we got a makeshift iron farm that I gotta fix. We have our cobblestone generator and we have a place to smelt things. And we got plenty of food all over the place. I've been using this food to trade up bricks like crazy. A little bit of a spoiler. The next build might have some bricks in it. I'm not too sure. We'll have to see and find out. But I'll see you in the next one. Bye.